الله وبركاته. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. وبعد، إخوتي الكرام، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل كما قال سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل آمين يا رب العالمين إن شاء الله I will be reminding myself and you all about the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which we heard many times before but as Quran says وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ remind each other as the reminder you know is beneficial for everyone for each other or for the believer وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ and most of the time brothers and sisters we know we have a knowledge about certain things certain ibadat but the important thing or the thing that is will be based off our success and falah will be the amal as one of the question that a person ibn adam will be asked Rasulullah said he will not be able to move his feet until he answers these five questions and one of them the knowledge that you have O my abd my slave how much did you implement that knowledge So implementation, always when we hear something, I have to reflect upon from an angle that how I can change my life, how I can implement this in my life, where is shortcomings in my life, how I can improve my iman, how I can improve my character. This hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in which he said, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس, take advantage of five, before five others. And Rasulullah sallallahu he was blessed with jawami' al-kalim, with comprehensive speech. Few words comprise of, you know, so much meaning, so much, you know, depth, that the scholars, they wrote books on that. In this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu he said, اغتنم خَمْسًا قَبْلَ خَمْسٍ, take advantage of these five before these five. The first he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said shababaka qabla haramik your youth before you become old so when a person is young he is shabab he has the quwwah he has power he has you know his objective maqsad in his life that he wants to achieve he had that zeal to do whatever he wants to he puts his effort his energy in that And at that time, if you take care of that benefit, the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with, the blessing of shabab, that's why Rasulullah said, seven people who will be under the shade of Allah on the day of judgment, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلْ And one of them will be, شَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ A young man who grew up, worshipping Allah. Allah bless you with shabab. You are young, but you make sure that you are praying on time. You make sure that at this stage of your life, when most of the people they are, their number one objective is how they can be better in their worldly life. There come that you make sure that there are rights of Allah that I need to fulfill. And you make sure that you're fulfilling that as well. And subhanAllah, you know, out of so many things, there are two things that a shabab, if he has or she has, inshaAllah, the falah will be in this dunya and the hereafter as well. One is the being righteous, as we're talking about. You know, being righteous means in terms of salah, in terms of being obedient towards or be kind towards parents and all those. You know, ibadat, and also a good companionship. Make sure that at that point when you are, especially when you are young, you are with those who can remind you about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sure you befriend with those people who reminds you about akhirah, about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. as it's been said that one of the quality of a friend is a righteous friend, that when you see him, just by looking at him, your iman increases. And there are so many benefits when a person has a righteous company, a righteous friend. You are in a gathering and you are have a righteous friend at the time of salah. What he will remind you? He will remind you of salah. He will remind you to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that you should take advantage of before you lose it, that is your health. Sihataka qabla saqamik. Allahu Akbar. Your health before you fall sick. Most of the time what happens, when we are sick, then we realize how blessed I was. So the blessing of health, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take advantage of it. We talked about it so many times, brothers and sisters. This, the ni'mah of eyes, the ni'mah of these hands, the ni'mah, subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, in the morning when you get up, the meaning of the hadith, if a person gets up in the morning and he has these two blessings, it means he possesses the whole world. He has whole world. What are those two blessings? One is the siha. He has the siha, he has health. And second is aman. He has a protection. His family is protected. Imagine this morning when you got up. You did not have someone did not have to take you to the bathroom. MashaAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with health. You walked. But there are thousands of people who cannot walk, who cannot use bathroom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with this ni'mah of siha. Utilize it in a way that pleases Allah. Use these eyes in reading the Quran. Make sure using these feet, walking towards the houses of Allah. Someone gave this very good example. And this is a reminder for us. Suppose someone says that you will be paid $50 for each salah that you will come to the masjid. If you come to the masjid, $50 will be given to you. What we will do, brothers and sisters? If we take this, you know, as an honest question, asking from ourselves, wallahi, we will say, even if I have to spend maybe 15 minutes, it's a bit out of the way, I am busy, but still it's $50. Just entering in the masjid and you will get it, you will pray and you will leave. I think most of us, we will at least try to come once visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He said, when a person comes to the masjid and he prays salah in the masjid, it's 25 or 27 times better than praying in the house. When we come to the house of Allah, masajid of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our host. And we come as a guest of Allah. Look at the honor that a person has. Rasulullah said, when you walk to the masjid, each step that you take, one of your sin is erased. And you raise one rank high. Allahu Akbar. And these hasanat, although these, we cannot see these dollars, $50. We cannot see these hasanat, which is 25 or 27 times better. When we will see this? We will see it in our book of deed on the day of judgment. When Allah will say, اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. Brothers and sisters, one of the way that we can utilize our health in a best possible way is visiting the houses of Allah frequently. بشر المشائين. Give glad tidings to those people who used to walk to the houses of Allah, masajid of Allah, in darkness. Meaning for Salatul Fajr and Salatul Isha. It's not easy. When you make an intention that you want to pray in the masjid, there will be 10 different thoughts that will come in your mind. Shaytan will whisper in your ear. And you know what? He will not give you any reasoning that is not logical, that doesn't make sense to you. That will make sense to you 100%. That's why we agree to it. So next time, make sure that when you have time, inshallah, try to visit the house of Allah even once in a day. or few times, it should not be only that you're visiting the house of Allah only on Fridays. Just start with one more day, one more time that you are visiting the house of Allah. Increase that, and wallahi, you will see the difference. Sometimes we complain, I don't have barakah in my house. My kids don't pray. I don't feel that, you know, that barakah in my time. All that is related to what we do. What is my ta'alluq billah? And especially for brothers, visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not only that you are coming in the house of Allah and you're praying. There's a lot of barakah and blessing attached to it. The concept of masjid, we cannot take it out from Muslim life. And subhanallah, one of the benefit that we get as a parent when we come to the masjid, we are teaching this, passing this to our next generation, our own children. Them coming visiting the house of Allah, it's not that we are just coming and praying, we are passing that to our children. And later on, inshallah, when they will be also among those people who visit the house of Allah. That's the quality of a believer, that he frequently visits the masjid. The hadith that I was talking about, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّي, 7 people under the shade of Allah, on the day of judgment when there will be no shade, one of the person will be رَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. Allahu Akbar. A man whose heart is not attached. مُعَلَّق means hanging, meaning he is out of the house of Allah. He is busy in his worldly life, but his heart is not there. His heart is in the masjid. He wants to go back. He is waiting, when is the next time when he can visit, he can go and visit the house of Allah. That is the quality of a believer. If we are missing that, if it doesn't move that we are sometime passing near the masjid and we cannot come to the masjid and spend few minutes and pray in the masjid, wallahi, there is some issue. There is some problem. So make sure, brothers and sisters, that we have strong connection with the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's one of the best way to be grateful to the ni'mah of sihha, the ni'mah of health, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take advantage of your health before you lose it. صِحَّتَكَ قَبْلَ سَقَمِكَ وَفَرَاغَكَ قَبْلَ شُغْلِكَ. The third thing Rasulullah said, take advantage of your free time before you become busy. You have free time. Sometimes we say, I'm killing my time. As a Muslim, we should not have much time. Always we should be worried about akhirah. We should be worried about, where am I standing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What is my ta'alluq billah? If I have to leave dunya now, where am I standing? Everyone can have that self-analysis, and it's very easy to know, where am I standing? If angel of death approaches me right now, where am I? So when we have a free time, make sure that we are utilizing that time in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Learn something about Quran. Just open up the Quran and try to memorize a few words. Try to understand those words. And that will also bring barakah, inshallah, in our lives. The fourth thing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take advantage of it before you lose it. And that is, غِنَاكَ قَبْلَ فَقْرِكَ. You have wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with wealth. Take advantage of it before you lose it. Who is Ar-Razzaq? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one, وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. He is the owner of the risk, the wealth that we have. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. There is, it's not an ihsan that when you give money to poor, to those who are in need, it's not ihsan, it's not favor. Is their haqq, is their right. وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. You know, subhanallah, this sadaqah, again, this famous hadith about those 7 categories of people, and one of them will be a person who spent in the way of Allah in a way that his left hand did not know what his right hand spent. This sadaqa, inna dhilla al-mu'mini yawm al-qiyamati sadaqatuhu. This sadaqa will become a dhil, a shade on the day of judgment for a believer. Inna sadaqata la tutfi'u ghadab al-rab. This sadaqa removes the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we spend in the way of Allah, it purifies our wealth. Khudh min amwalihim sadaqatan tutahhiruhum wa tuzakkihim biha wa salli alayhim. So when we spend in the way of Allah, Allah's promises, wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. Allah will pay us back in many, many, many folds. And that's the promise of Allah in so many places. The quality of people of taqwa, the quality of those people for whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared the jannah, about which he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, u'iddat lil muttaqeen wa jannatin 'arduha as-samawati wal ard u'iddat lil muttaqeen. The first quality Allah mentioned, alladhina yunfiquna fis sarai wa tarra. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, what is the best form of charity? What is the best form of charity? Sometime what happens, we fall sick, something happens, and then we say, let me give in charity. Let me give sadaqah. Rasulullah was asked, or he asked from Sahaba, the meaning of the hadith, what is best form of charity? Ayyu sadaqati khayr. He said, the form of the time that when you spend and you have a fear that your money will decrease. You're not in test from Allah, but you spend in the way of Allah, and you have fear that it will decrease, but still you spend in the way of Allah. In Muslim's life, there should not be a single day when he is not spending something in the way of Allah. We always say that quantity doesn't matter, quality matters. $1 can worth more than $1,000. That's why this famous hadith, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated, about those three people who will be the very first. The three people who will held accountable. The very first one will be the shaheed, the alim, the qari of the Quran, and the third will be ghani. Allah will ask him, what did you do with the wealth that I blessed you with? He will say, Allah, I spend whole wealth in your way. Allah will say, you did it. But you did it so people can call him, MashaAllah, look at this person, how generous he is. There was riya in it. There was showing off in it. So the quality matters, not the quantity. Even you spend $1, but spend it in a way that, as Rasulullah mentioned the hadith, your left hand does not know what your right hand is spending in the way of Allah. And this sadaqah will be burhan. As Rasulullah said, as-sadaqatu burhanun. This sadaqah will be a source of protection for you. As we mentioned, will remove the anger of Allah, will be shared on the day of judgment. And last thing, Rasulullah mentioned in the hadith, take advantage of this before you lose it. And that is, subhanAllah, hayataka qabla mawtik. Take advantage of the life that Allah bless you with before you lose it. The life, this life that you and me, we have, it's an amana from Allah. It's an amana from Allah. And when the angel of death will approach us, we will not have a single moment. وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. O insan, O human being, إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. Every day that is passing by, you are getting closer to meet who? To meet Allah. إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. Every khutbah, the imam recites this verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ. O you who believe, fear Allah and be wise, be smart. Of what? Not that how much your bank balance is now compared to the last year. مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ. Lighad in Arabic means, ghadan means tomorrow. What you put forth for tomorrow. And here, as Mufassirin say in the tafsir, tomorrow means for the day of judgment. This is how close it is. This is how close it is. That tomorrow can be for me and for you. Maybe it can be today. Then the angel of death can take away my life or your life. We can leave this dunya anytime. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْكَيِّسُ مَنْ دَانَ نَفْسَهُ وَعَمِلَ لِمَا بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ. What is in my account of good deeds? You know, we were talking about it after Isha Khatira as well. Those pockets of investments that we have on daily basis. There's an investment account of Salah. There is an investment account of Salah. How is my Salah? What is the standard of my Salah? There is an investment account of Sadaqah, of our Mu'amalat, Hukuk al-Ibad, Hukuk Allah. Make sure the way we keep looking in our, you know, our bank accounts, the same way we have to look these accounts as well. How is my Salah? Just take, have the analysis of your Salah in the last 5 or 6 days. How many Salah you prayed on time? How many Salah you prayed in the masjid? And what is the quality of your Salah? Maybe some of us, we miss few prayers. Some of us, we prayed in-house. We always can improve. Those brothers and sisters were praying 5 times in a day. On time, alhamdulillah, trying to pray in the masjid. Look for tahajjud salah, for extra nawafil that can bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And same goes with other investment accounts as well. As Allah says, وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. So be smart. Make sure that we are investing in those accounts that we will see with Allah. تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, take advantage of 5 before 5. Take advantage of your youth before you become old. Take advantage of your siha, your health, before you lose it, before you become sick. Take advantage of your free time before you become busy. Take advantage of your health before you become poor. And take advantage of your life before death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those who take advantage of all these 5 things. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those that whose end will be khatima bil iman, khatima bil ihsan. And when we are leaving this dunya, the kalima shahada, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna muhammadan rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is on our tongue. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha, wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum, fa astaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قال سبحانه: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان. يا مالك الملك ويا أرحم الراحمين، اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا وجعلنا مسلمين لك ومن ذريتنا أمة مسلمة لك. يا مالك الملك هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم ومن عذاب القبر ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال. يا مالك الملك ويا أرحم الراحمين اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا، رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا، رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأخي الصلاة.